When my friend Brad needed to buy a minivan for hauling his kids around town, he went to the car dealership and he picked one out. But when Brad needed a completely customized military truck made for promoting his business, he didn't even think about going back to the dealership to get that.
And then as soon as the person up there starts walking off and they're done, you walk on, your microphones are never coming off, ever, the whole night.
My company, Trailer Bid, was started to take some of the purchasing pain out of the process for customers who are wanting a custom enclosed trailer.
Now on to the best 3 minutes of your life.
So if you go to a typical trailer dealership, they only want to move products that they've got in stock off their lot. But if you want something custom from the ground up, like a food trailer or a work trailer that is designed to meet a specific need, that's where we come in.
I work with each and every one of my customers one-on-one to have their trailer designed and built for their exact needs.
What I have no interest in doing is being just like every other dealer and trying to just compete and slash my prices and beat them on that. I really wanted to solve a problem in the market, and it took me about a year to really figure out what that was going to look like moving forward.
In 2014, this model helped me generate revenues of $685,000.
Yes, I do think that there's a lot of capital in Kansas City. There are investors in Kansas City actively looking for businesses to invest in. And so it is a right market for people to go out and do that. It's just a matter of learning and understanding who they are and what they're looking for and how to get in front of them. For people who are willing to go out and be aggressive to go after it, then I think that they'll find it. And it's a matter of finding the right people and then picking their brain and figuring out what are investors looking for, what do they want to see.
What we intend to do is do what Netflix did to Blockbuster.
This is the product that I launched the brand with.
Now, my background is purely in small business. I've been involved in small business management since I moved to Kansas City 12 years ago. And I was very wet behind the ears. Got a chance to work for a small company, worked my way up the ladder, ended up managing that business and loved it. And so I've known for a while that having a company of my own is something that I was passionate about and wanted to do. I have been learning through good times and bad times and through good situations and difficult situations. There are days where I've gone home and asked my wife, why am I not just working a job where I can punch a pay card and collect a check? And there are other days I've gone home and said, we're the luckiest people in the world.